if the church can no longer attract young people, it has to be that they're not taking that with sufficient seriousness.
Jordan Peterson and Bishop Barron recently had a conversation in which they pinpointed one particular issue that causes people to walk away from the church. I was pleasantly surprised and inspired by their findings, which is why I decided to make a video about it, and I hope that you will be encouraged by what I'm about to tell you. My name is Lucas, by the way, and this is my channel Deflate, which challenges skeptics, strengthens believers, and creates a space for awesome discussions about God. You'll find the link to the original conversation between Peterson and Barron in the description box below. It went on for nearly 2 hours, and so I will only be able to give you a summary of what I think is one of its key takeaways. I've left what I believe to be Peterson's most powerful anecdote of that conversation for the end of my video, as it summarizes so well the key point I want to talk about. So stick with me. Let's get started. At around halfway into their conversation, Barron elaborates on the significance of Christ's self-sacrifice on the cross. One of the things he says is that even though man killed God, God returned in forgiving love. This means that divine goodness and forgiveness can trump any evil, and Barron concludes that that's how Christianity is born. In response to that, Jordan picks up the key Christian notion that we are to become like Christ, to become the ideal, as he puts it, and he understands that this kind of logically implies the confrontation with suffering. In other words, Peterson captures in his own words what the Apostle Paul already taught, which is that if we are to be transformed into the image of Christ, then this means that we are to go through suffering, just as Christ did on his way to the cross. From that, Peterson moves on to say this, listen very closely.
And this isn't hit home. It's like, look what the church demands everything of you.
Yeah.
Absolutely everything. And the reason that people are leaving is because that adventure isn't being put before them.
Yes.
It's like, look, you can have your cars and your money and all of that, but that's nothing compared to the adventure that you could be going on.
Yes, I wish you'd preach to our people, because I think you're absolutely right about that.
So here is what Peterson is suggesting and why Bishop Barron wants him to preach even louder. The reason why people are leaving the church is because it is not inviting them to the challenging adventure of becoming like Christ, but it is selling a shallow kind of happiness instead. Or to put it simply, it's not because the church makes it too hard for people, but because it makes it too easy for them that they are walking away.
We talked a little bit before about the church bleeding its people. They're leaving. The young people are leaving. And my sense of that is it's because the church does not demand enough of its of young people.
Yeah, I think that's right.
Doesn't demand enough. And by not demanding enough, it doesn't indicate its faith in their possibility.
Now, when it comes to this notion of faith in the possibility of young people, Peterson moves on to make a very interesting connection to an idea that is unmistakably Petersonian. Everyone who is familiar with his work will love this. It's an idea which, in his public speaking, would always reduce his audience to complete and utter silence, as he himself remembers.
Sometimes that silence can be dramatic, and that's why people say, well, you could have heard a pin drop. It's no one's moving, because their attention is 100% gripped by whatever just happened. And one thing that reliably elicited that was the proposition that the meaning that sustains you and protects you from corruption during suffering is to be found in responsibility. And people that And I thought part of the reason that produced silence was because no one says that now. They say happiness, or they say rights, or they say privileges, or they say reward, or something like that. They don't say, pick up the heaviest load you can carry, for that matter, and stumble forward.
If you followed Peterson on YouTube or read his books, you will know that the notion of you taking responsibility for your life is one of the things, if not the thing, he has become famous for. Now, it seems that in his conversation with Bishop Barron, he takes this exact notion and gives it a Christian spin by saying that according to Christianity, when a follower of Jesus goes through suffering, his or her responsibility is to hang in there and stumble forward on his or her journey toward the likeness of Christ. I might misunderstand Peterson, but he seems to be compelled by this Christian vision of suffering as it places our struggle and pain within the grand narrative of reality, thus rendering our suffering deeply meaningful.
You need to be engaged in something that's deeply meaningful enough to justify the suffering. And so, you know, part of what happens in the story of Christ is the only thing deep enough to justify that level of suffering is absolute immersion in a cosmic drama. And then you ask yourself, well, are we each immersed in a cosmic drama? And it's not so easy to say no to that. It's a life or death situation.
Now, it's important to mention the following. At no point in the conversation does Peterson give even the slightest impression that this notion of us participating in a cosmic drama as we go through suffering should render the suffering itself any less dreadful. Given what he and his family have been through over the past year or so, he knows perfectly well that suffering is as real as anything can be. What he is saying, however, is that the Christian story infuses our experience of suffering with ultimate significance. And while I might be misreading things, I think you can really feel how he wrestles with that tension between the horror and the meaningfulness of our suffering, both of which are realities which the Christian story affirms 100%. At the same time, Peterson is bewildered by the fact that even though the church would have such a powerful story to tell when it comes to the human condition, people are still walking away. And so he asks very innocently why this is so.
So then what's wrong with what you guys are doing? Why isn't it working? Well, what's the problem?
It's true that we're not doing enough of that. And I do think we've succumbed a bit to the modern thing, which is a preoccupation with rights and freedom and my individuality and so on.
So Barron agrees with Peterson that people are leaving the church because we have edited out from our message the challenge of becoming like Christ. This is why he goes on to say,
we dumbed it down intellectually and we lessened the moral demand for sure, because we didn't want, I think, people to run away. And then, you know, I'll say it bluntly, rather pathetically, we tried to be as relevant as possible. That was the term from our time.
You know, right, and that's like the uncool guy at the party, man.
Right.
You know, if you have to strive to be relevant, you're not on the cutting edge, that's for sure.
Right.
Now, I couldn't agree more with Peterson and Barron. I mean, I don't know how many times I've heard Christians in general and Christian leaders in particular talk about the need for the church to be relevant. And while people seem to think that this is simply another way of talking about contextualizing the gospel in the 21st century, it's basically code language for, we don't have the guts to talk about what it really means to follow Christ, and we prefer to lower the bar and water down the cost of discipleship, because the easier our standards are, the more people will flock to our church. But there are two problems with this. First, it amounts to preaching what Dietrich Bonhoeffer would have called cheap grace. The true gospel, however, comes with what Bonhoeffer called costly grace, as it invites us to follow the one who gave himself up for us, but also calls us to take up our cross and deny ourselves. And second, I agree with Peterson that people actually want to be challenged. They are looking for an adventure that demands everything of them. Now, sure, it's also true that we all like to indulge ourselves. We are all tempted to pursue the comfortable life, or as Peterson would put it, to remain in our parents' basement playing video games instead of taking responsibility. This is why, in their conversation, Bishop Barron pushes back against Peterson and mentions that there needs to be a Gandalf who summons the hobbits out of their hobbit holes, because these holes are just too cozy for Bilbo Baggins and his friends to leave behind in return for an adventure in the wild. In other words, it would be a misreading of human nature to say that we're all unconditionally dedicated to pursuing the challenging life Christ calls us to. However, it is just as fatal a misreading of human nature to think that we're not up for any challenge at all, and it's this second mistake which Peterson and Barron pin on the church. they challenge us to regain confidence in the truth that there is a hero slumbering within us who waits to be awakened. They call the church to stop feeling embarrassed for the fact that following Christ leads through suffering, and they encourage us to tell the actual cosmic drama called Christianity and not a cheapened version of it. Peterson captures this beautifully in that personal anecdote I mentioned at the beginning.
If that story that the church is telling is not being taken up, it's not being sold, there's something about it that's not being sold properly. I'm not saying I have the answer to
that's true.
You know? But like, I saw this kid once when I was in Montreal, and he was about 17 years old, and he was big guy, big, like 6'5" guy, and a physical specimen. And he was standing on the corner of a shopping area, and he had two pink shopping bags in his hands, and he looked kind of bereft. And I thought, you know, if you came up to him and said, I've got some heroism in battle for you around the corner, he'd drop those, and you said it right, he'd drop those damn pink shopping bags in a second and be off for the adventure of his life.
Yeah.
Is it a lack of faith that a fundamental faith that is sapping the lifeblood out of that story? Because you're saying, well, here, I'm calling you to an adventure that's as great as any adventure you could possibly conceive. By definition, this is the ultimate adventure that you're being called to.
Now, I'm moved by Peterson's innocent kind of bewilderment as he rightly discerns the striking discrepancy between the actual story of Christianity and what the church sells as its story. It's also striking that he doesn't claim to have the solution, and he goes on to mention that his point is not even to blame the church, but to simply offer his personal analysis of where modern Christianity is at. I second that, by the way, all the more so as I have to admit that I've been guilty of lowering the bar sometimes and of inviting people to a distorted, happy-clappy version of Christianity rather than to the challenging adventure of becoming like Christ through suffering. Nevertheless, I'm beyond grateful for and inspired by Peterson and Barron, who have pinpointed what I believe to be the key challenge the church is facing today, and I believe we ought to take their message very seriously. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and check out this video, which tells the story of a skeptic who changed his mind on prayer after experiencing miraculous relief from tremendous suffering. Thank you for watching, and see you over there.